This computer is responsible for basically every video you've ever seen on this YouTube channel. I built this in 2019, I got a tax return, and I needed a new system. So I actually built basically two of these systems. And like I said, this has been responsible for every tutorial, every video, every live stream. Everything that's ever been released on this channel has probably had this computer involved in it in some capacity. I will say there's a couple of caveats. This GPU is not the one that's been in there forever. I needed one last video out of this, and I had taken the GPU out for something else that we're actually going to talk about in this video. But like I said, this PC is 6 years old. It's got a Ryzen 5 2600 in it with 32 gigs of RAM and about 6 years worth of dust down there on the bottom. And this is my new system to replace the system that I've had for about the last 6 years. This is the Minisforum UM880 Plus. We actually did a live stream about this not too long ago. Obviously, this is just a USB interface for my microphone, but that is the Minisforum UM880 Plus, and this is the USB interface for that microphone. But it just fits like nearly perfectly on top of there. So that's where I put it. There we go. And then over here, this is the GPU that was over in that system. Again, that is a Quadro P2000 that I've had in there for a little while because I needed this RTX 2070 to put into my new system. And when I say that, I mean, I wanted to put a GPU on this system because I've always been really curious about these Oculink GPU docks. And when I asked Minisforum about a collaboration, I asked if I could get one of these DEG1s to go with the UM880, and they said yes. So here we are, and that's what we're going to talk about in today's video. So one of the things that I found kind of interesting about this setup is that obviously we can see a power button here and we can see a power button here. But if we did press this power button, nothing happens. Even coming into my operating system, nothing happens. But if I do something like shut down Windows, we'll give that a second to shut down. And hopefully this won't decide to do an update in the meantime. And here we can see it shut down. And at the same time, the GPU also, this whole system powered off together, which I think is great. I actually really like that I don't have to try to manually remember to turn this off. Now I can turn this on like that for some reason, but that doesn't affect this. And I find that weird. So I'm just gonna press and hold this. I'm gonna turn that back off just because it doesn't seem to make any sense to have this running without this, but I press that, then this automatically turns back on. I love that I can turn this on and off automatically with the mini PC. That's just how it works. I didn't do anything custom there. So overall, just the way they've tied this together is super effective, but a little weird that this has its own power button that I just don't understand. And if you do, let me know in the comment section, why does that need its own power button? I genuinely don't understand that. But this is the current setup that I've got. We've talked about that a little bit. So now let's actually dig into the device itself and talk about what's inside, the IO ports, that sort of thing, and dig into this device a little. Okay, so here we have the Minisforum UM880 Plus. Looks pretty good. Nice little silver finish on there, a little dust or something. It will attract some fingerprints if you notice there at that angle. Head on, not too bad. At an angle, definitely easier to notice. That said, if we move over to the front, we get a little microphone, power button, a couple of USB 3.2 ports, combo headphone microphone jack there, and a CMOS BIOS reset. Got to stick a little thing in there to reset that if you want to. On the different sides, on the right side there and on the left, we get a decent amount of air intake. And same on the bottom. I know these feet are in the right place. That's because I've been in here several times. The screws are over here. I just got tired of fighting with it, so I moved them, and it works. You also got a couple of slots here for a VESA mount adapter if you wanted to screw this to the back of your monitor. On the back, we get an exhaust, 19-volt barrel jack adapter, 2.5 gig LAN. Love seeing that. HDMI 2 or 2.1, I don't remember. I'll have to put that on the screen. Oculink port, we're going to come back to this. USB 4 port, display port, I believe this is 1.4, and a couple of USB 2 ports. And that is all you're going to get. Not a ton of I.O. And that, I think that's kind of the low point for me on this is just the four USB ports seems a little bit lacking in my opinion, but it is what it is. So let's take the bottom off. Let's get under here. Like so, there we go. Now, it does tell you right here to be super careful with this. Disconnect internal cable when lifting the lid. I don't think that's a great way to word that, because you can't disconnect the cable without lifting the lid. And there is that cable. And what I do dig about this is that this cable is for the fan that cools this plate right here that then actually connects to, these two NVMe slots. This, obviously, going to be your storage. It comes with a terabyte of NVMe storage from Kingston. Love seeing that. What I didn't love seeing was this. I'm actually going to take that out. So, quick little unscrew here. And then this comes out, and there we go. So, when you first get it, it looks like this, more or less. And so you've got two NVMe slots for storage. Also, 32 gigs of DDR5. Don't want to forget that. From Crucial, again, love seeing good quality product in here. But then as I was going through the unboxing process that I covered in the live stream, I saw this and I was like, well, what is this? That's interesting. And then I realized this is the Oculink port that we're going to use for that DEG1. And then I realized, oh, if I want to use this, I got to take up this NVMe slot here, and I'm going to lose that for storage. So I was a little bummed about that. I don't know why they didn't include it as a native port on the motherboard. This is not the first mini PC I've seen with an Oculink port built into it, and it didn't obstruct one of the NVMe ports. So I was a little bummed to see this, but just that quickly, we can get that installed. And that, of course, will give us access to that Oculink adapter that we're going to take a look at here in just a minute. Let's make sure I get this screw back in here so I don't forget. I will definitely forget if I don't do this right now. There we go. And just that easily, we've got this new Oculink port in here. If you don't want to use that, I believe there it is. There is this little rubber thing here that would actually cover this Oculink hole in the back, so you wouldn't just have an open thing in there. But overall, it's going to make you choose. Do you want the extra storage or do you want the Oculink? And I think that's kind of a bummer. But that's the device in a nutshell as far as the going around it. I believe I actually read somewhere that they don't want you to go any deeper than what I just showed, because you may end up messing up. I believe there is liquid metal as the thermal interface material for the cooling system on this. I may be mistaken, but I feel like I read that somewhere. So just something to be aware of. Overall, device runs great. Rarely ever makes any sound, even under full load. So now that we've taken a look at the overview of the UM880 Plus from Minisforum, this is the DEG1, also, like it says right there, from Minisforum. And this is a GPU adapter, I guess is what you would want to call it, but technically it's just a PCI Express port that you can run some power to and connect to your PC via this Oculink port via this cable right here that kind of looks like a DisplayPort cable of sorts. But this is how you can connect this device to your mini PC. It's actually pretty unremarkable in that if you take the bottom off, like you can hear, there's just a board in there. There's nothing special going on. There are no additional ports on here other than this Oculink port right there. Of course, you can mount a power supply there. Couple of screws, but nothing else other than the power button there that we took a look at earlier. And that's it. Like that's the whole thing. But again, I did ask them to send this to me because I've really wanted to check one of these out for a while. In order to do that, however, I did need to supply my own power supply. This is a Silverstone model SST SX500LG. This is an SFXL power supply. There it is, the SX580 Plus Gold. And I didn't need anything super high power because I'm just going to be powering a GPU with it, not an entire system. So this little mounting bracket did come with this, so something to keep in mind. This is so you can have a mounting bracket for your GPU. So I'll get this put back together real quick. I used some thumb screws. So, and one more right here, like so. And then, of course, you will want to plug your GPU, or sorry, your power supply into this so that, you know, you can give power where it needs to go. hopefully that is good enough. I didn't hear a click, but I'll tell you, getting this apart a minute ago was a real pain. And then, of course, we've got our GPU here. It just kind of goes in like that. I will say there is no locking, like, retaining clip on this device, so just something to keep in mind. You don't get one of those with this. I don't know that you'll need one, though. And then just a single thumb screw to hold it in place, just like so. And it's solid. Like, it's definitely not going anywhere. Really, really dig that. Okay, so here we are, just a couple of minutes later. Everything's hooked back up, ready to go. And again, I love that I can just press that button and everything powers on as if it was an entire fully built tower PC. Everything just comes on all at once. I absolutely love that. So at this point, I want to talk a little bit about gaming on the UM880 Plus from Minisforum with their DEG1 PCI Express GPU dock thing with a 2070. Now, keeping in mind, the RTX 2070 is like 6 years old, maybe even more at this point. So let's keep that in mind as we're going through some of these settings and the results that we see with the two games we're going to take a look at. First is going to be Rise of the Tomb Raider. And if we jump over here to my desktop, we can see that I went with the DirectX 12 setup, full screen, exclusive full screen with 1080p. The DLSS was set to quality, 60 hertz refresh rate, VSync off, stereoscopic 3D off. And then if we jump over to our graphics, the preset is custom. Basically, everything here set to very high, just out of the box. Now, I also want to say that I am not good at picking the right settings. I just kind of run with whatever it says that it can do, and then I turn things off like motion blur, that sort of thing, just because I don't like motion blur in my video games. But most of the settings that I play with my games are kind of the default settings, unless I, even in my monkey brain, can see that there's something very, very wrong. So that's what we're going to take a look at here, is kind of going with what the game defaulted to and motion blur turned off. So if we come back over here, we can kind of see everything here. Motion blur is off, lens flares are on, screen effects are on, film grain is on. Everything's set to high or very high for the most part. And then if we jump over and click back, and then we should be able to go back again and start the benchmark here. We're going to give this just a second to do its thing and get started up. There it is. Look, it's not super high resolution. This is technically an older game, and we don't have all of the settings cranked all of the way up, but this actually looks pretty good, all things considered here. No lagging, no stuttering, nothing like that going on. And of course, look, I captured this with my phone, and we're watching that video file because, of course, capturing the game with the PC that I'm gaming on, it would have been a nightmare. This system can't handle that, but it can handle this game very, very well, despite that little stutter you may have seen there briefly. And of course, this all looks really good. All of that looks great. Again, those transitions are good. No weird aberrations or anything like that. So when we actually got to the results of that test, I did switch over and record this with PC for some reason that I can't really explain, other than that's what I felt I needed to do. But if we take a look at this, we can see Mountain Peak got 162, Syria got 110, Geothermal Valley got 86 with an overall of about 120. And of course, yes, we're going to see some minimum frames in there of like 5 or 16 or whatever, right? But as those different tests were going through, yes, there was a couple of hiccups here and there. Sometimes just jumping into a scene, you'll have a brief moment of like 5 FPS, but it doesn't really distract from the game all that much in the grand scheme of things. Hiccups happen, that sort of thing. Again, keeping in mind, this is a mini PC and a GPU that is 6+ years old at this point. So overall, I'm really, really happy with how the results came off with Rise of the Tomb Raider. And one other game I want to look at real quick is actually Cyberpunk 2077, because it's also a great looking game. Okay, and here we can kind of see the quick preset settings that are set up for the graphics on Cyberpunk 2077. The quick preset is custom. DLSS is set to super resolution with the transformer model, and the super resolution set to auto. No sharpness, nothing ray related, no ray tracing, no ray reconstruction, no frame generation, and the texture quality, and basically everything else in this set to high, except for motion blur. I think I got that turned off. Let's make sure I did motion blur. Motion blur is actually set to high. I missed that apparently. But overall, you can kind of see the settings that are going on here. VSync is off, maximum FPS is off, full screen, 1080p HDR off. And as we jump in here, we can see that we're immediately at like 70 FPS for this part of the scene. As I was going through this test initially, I didn't really see any hiccups or stutters or anything that would actually detract from the gameplay or bring you out of that immersive experience that you get with a game like this. So we jump out to the outside. We're in the mid 80s here. It's going to fluctuate a little bit depending on where we are. Mid 90s there for just a moment for part of that, which is to kind of be expected there. But again, we're still in the mid 80s. We're kind of sinking down into the mid 70s here. But it's very, very consistent, and it just feels very, very good to go through this and not see any of the stuttering or anything that would actually detract from the gameplay. And as we spin around, this will wrap up in the low 90s. Of course, I say that. There it is. So our average FPS, 79.59. Our minimum FPS was 65.74, max of about 96.5. Again, we're using that RTX 2070 with 8 gigs of RAM on a high preset, more or less, at 1080p full screen. And I gotta say, like, this isn't going to be a gaming PC for me. I just really wanted to test this out and see what kind of gaming experience you could expect to see with a setup like this, with a UM880 Plus, the DEG1, and a GPU that's like 6+ years old. And I'm super, super happy with all of the results I got all the way through testing this setup. So I've been using this as my primary setup out here in my little studio space since like April 6th, give or take. We did the live stream of the unboxing and kind of the initial setup on April 5th. And I just basically immediately got it all set up. I've done some cable management since then. But any of the videos that you've seen released on this channel since, let's call it the 5th or the 6th of April of 2025, have been done on the UM880 Plus and the DEG1 with the 2070. And overall, I love that it's a much more small, compact setup that just takes up a little bit of space under my desk or under my monitor here, not my desk, my monitor. It runs quietly. It runs cool. I don't hear it. Now, that is to say, if I were to actually do any gaming out here, which I probably never will, because the GPU is literally right under my monitor, the fan noise is considerably more than you would expect it to be if it was in, say, a full case that was enclosed, right? So there are going to be some trade-offs with a setup like this. But for my needs, what I'm doing out here, this new setup works so, so well for me. I'm super, super happy with everything that's going on here. And I'm really thankful to Minisforum for giving me the opportunity to check this out, both the mini PC and the GPU dock. Super happy with all of it. So thank you to Minisforum for this opportunity to check all this out. Also, I want to say thank you to you guys for taking a few minutes of your day to spend here with me today to kind of hear me ramble about this new setup that I'm so, so happy with. Again, as I mentioned earlier in the video, links to everything will be in the video description. If there are any comments you got about how I screwed something up here, definitely leave those in the comment section down below. If you want to check out anything, again, links down there in the video description. But I think with that said, I'm going to wrap this up. I do want to thank you again for spending a few minutes of your day with me here today. And I'll talk to you in the next video.